Vengo anch'io. Ma sì, ha ragione lei, sto sbagliando tutto. Stiamo sbagliando tutto.
I think the best example of mother energy in popular culture right now, it's easy, is Ayesha Curry. She is kind of like the girl next door. She comes across as very warm, as friendly, as affable. Like she's an attractive woman, and you know that she lives a lifestyle that a lot of other women don't, yet there's something about her that seems normal and approachable, like literally the girl next door. And that's kind of what the mother energy is. Mother is all about nurturing life, protecting life. And so at the most basic level, and this is probably next to the lover, along with the lover, the most ancient and powerful and intrinsic feminine archetype, the lover and the mother, because they fulfill both instincts to procreate and sustain life, you know, raise a child and that child survives. So on the most intrinsic level, the mother represents that desire to nurture and sustain. And that can be in a number of ways. That can be physically nurturing, like a woman breastfeeding a child or feeding a child or taking care of a child, but it could be spiritually nurturing. It could be emotionally nurturing, being a source of emotional support. A lot of times, women who identify with the mother archetype, if they go out in a group of friends, they're the ones that are, you know, making sure everybody's okay. They might be the designated driver, and they're making sure everybody's all right. These women tend to be approachable. These women tend to be down to earth, you know, not too pretentious. Their energy is very warm. Their energy tends to be very inviting. That's actually one of the most enchanting things about them, is that they're, I won't say there's no mystery, but you feel at ease in their presence. These women tend to be very resilient, and they embrace the notion of family, whether that family is kin, their circle of friends, or their community, or even their country. In popular culture, you've seen the mother. She's Harriet Winslow. She is June Cleaver. She's Carol Brady, Julia Child. And on a larger, more humanitarian notion of this archetype, she's Mother Teresa, you know, who represents the concept of mothering humanity. Mothers are nourishers, and they are sustainers, and they fight for the causes and the people that matter to them most. They are determined. And again, like the lover, this is the most ancient primordial archetype. It represents our capacity to not only give birth, but also to sustain life. One of the reasons why women who have dominant lover and mother energy are so seductive is because both of these energies, both these archetypes, are really the most ancient feminine archetypes there are, and the most essential and the most instinctive. And so if you see a Sophia Loren or if you see a Nia Long, and there's something about them that's just palpable, just oozes off the screen, it's like an earthy magnetism. That's why it is literally that most ancient force emanating from them. Even in Erykah Badu, who has plenty of huntress, but also that huntress is combined with lover and mother energy, and it makes her, it gives her a sort of earthy presence, where as different and eccentric as she is, there's something warm and even nurturing about her. And if you watch the case study in the Five Laws of Feminine Power of Erykah Badu, that's part of her unique seductive appeal. It's not just that she is a challenge due to that huntress nature, but there's also part of her that is incredibly nurturing. And men, you know, men sometimes want to be mothered. That actually can be a seductive thing. The other side of that is that for women who do have ample amounts of lover and mother, or who have mother energy and are attempting to cultivate lover energy and to get that balance, it can be difficult. And it can be difficult due to our patriarchal society and this whole idea of the Madonna whore complex, and the fact that we kind of teach women that you can, we kind of separate sex from the process of mothering, you know. So this idea of the ultimate virgin mother, this Madonna, that once you become a mother, you know, you're kind of asexual, versus if you are a sexual being, that's not motherly. We've separated these two spheres. We've taken these ancient energies and these ancient archetypes, and we've really twisted them to a point where we can't even recognize them anymore. So for that reason, a lot of women who identify with mother and lover, or either of those two, have a hard time really making sense of their energy and tapping into the real power of their energy. Because if you're looking to society to kind of help you find your identity, you're going to find a very distorted concept of your identity. And so a lot of times, again, for women who really identify with that mother energy, it takes them a bit of understanding to kind of really embrace their sexuality and sensuality as well.
Come on, Annie, think of something clever to say, huh? Something full of magic, religion, bullshit. Come on, dazzle me. What?
I said I want you.
Another interesting thing about mothers, they tend to be very down to earth, very approachable. Jill Scott, Oprah, Michelle Obama, Dolly Parton, Susan Sarandon, all of these women have ample amounts of mother energy. I know I said that both Oprah and Michelle Obama are sage women, but they also have ample amounts of mother energy. And that's actually what makes them approachable. If you look at Michelle Obama, you know, when she got into the White House, what did she call herself? She called herself Mom in Chief. And we knew she was an intelligent woman. We knew she was Princeton and Harvard Law. We knew she could give a speech just as fiery as her husband, but she made mothering her priority. And she made, you know, childhood obesity, you know, working with children and gardening, these very sort of mothering activities high in her agenda. It reflects, number one, her strategy as first lady, because she is a sage, but it also reflects that aspect of her personality, that mothering instinct is a really big part of her personality, and one of the things that makes her so approachable. Oprah Winfrey would be the same way. Oprah is obviously, you know, a sage, obviously a businesswoman, has really contributed a lot to the enlightenment of humanity, but what really makes her remarkable is the fact that she might sit down in an interview, and at the end of the interview, both of the people, she and the person, are crying. There's something open about her, something disarming about her, and that comes from that mother energy. So we cultivate this energy, all of us, when we need to literally mother. So a lot of women will really experience this energy on a biological level, like the hormones kicking in when they start families and when they become mothers, and it's like it comes on strong when you're connecting to your baby, and that archetype, you know, enters your life with a hurricane force and never leaves. But this energy also helps us transcend ego, and it helps us connect. It helps us create heart-centered, real, down-to-earth relationships with our friends, with our families. It lets us go from a place of kind of just being heady and, you know, nice conversation to really establishing heart-based emotional deep roots. And so for women that, again, that are looking to create something deep with the man and to go deeper with the man, not just, you know, because the seduction is tantalizing and it's heady, but at a certain point, once, you know, the seduction is really kicked in, you got to take it from the chase to something, you know, with roots. That's what the mother energy does. The mother energy is also seductive because, you know, you're a purveyor of creature comforts. There's something about going to, something about creating a home and creating a space that's warm and inviting, and, you know, a nice cooked meal and cozying up by the fire. And there's something about, you know, a woman that is just approachable, and you feel like, you know, you can confide in her and you feel like she's your friend. Mother energy kind of does that. For seduction, just for anything, you have to be able to access all seven of these archetypes. That's kind of the advantage of the mother archetype, at least in seduction. And mother energy also opens up the floodgates of compassion, emotional connection, and creation. And it helps us really recognize and cater to the needs of others. And that's an invaluable tool, not only in nurturing, but also when it comes to charm and seduction.